Dear friends, welcome to Civil Conclave Group. Today we are going to discuss about system types, design of plumbing and sanitation work procedures. It's a Civil Conclave presentation. Basic requirement of a planning. The sort of a plumbing framework utilized in a buildings are single stake or a super lead framework. Types and determination of material being utilized. Example, regardless of whether CEI or on other brand PVC pipes for waste and whether CEI PVC AC pipe for a stormwater stakes. Arrangements of underground tanks or tanks with the recommended links. A different siphoning framework for providing civil drinking water and to the kitchen straightforwardly. The need of putting out fires frameworks dependent on legal arrangement. Is adequate civil drinking water is accessible? Is there some other wellspring of water nearby? For example, open well, tube well, etc. Is accessible water consumable? If not, would it be made consumable with some treatment strategies? Finish the sewerage removal framework. Is the civil sewer line accessible for the undertaking at what reverse level? If the septic tank is required, settle on the area of the septic tank. Connect with an expert for plumbing and sterilization work method to set up the drawing and subletes ahead of time. This should be done before the start of the ventures. Basics of the plumbing system. Sterilized seepage framework to convey the wastewater from the pipes apparatuses. Sterilized seepage framework to convey the wastewater from the pipes apparatuses to people in general or private removal framework. Stormwater seepage framework to gather and convey water. Putting out fire frameworks for call structures according to the legal arrangements. All structure may not require this. Plumbing and sanitation work procedures. That's the norms. Water supply system. Sufficient amount of spotless and consumable water for drinking purpose should be provided. Water from different sources ought to be likewise made accessible for a day-to-day use for 24 hours effective flushing. Appropriate siphoning frameworks with satisfactory reserve plans should be made. Water should be provided with the necessary weight up to overall tank and afterwards to the individual private units with the base recommended pressure. The framework ought to summon least support. This is the image of the water treatment plant if the water is required for further treatment. Plumbing fixtures and pipes. The plumbing fixtures should be smoothly finished for uninterrupted flow. Located in the enclosure ducts. Easily accessible for the intended use and repairs. Able to withstand design pressure. Connected to the drainage system with the water seal traps. Tested for leakages, defects, etc. The plumbing side pipes should be made of durable material and connected by a suitable and satisfactory joints of good workmanship. For satisfactory services during its reasonable life expectancy and easily accessible for inspection, working and repairs. Made rodent proof, that is example rat, mouse, squirrel, etc. Tested for leakages, defects, etc. Sanitary and drainage system. It should be well designed, executed, operated and maintained according to the standards and as per the local authority, municipal authority norms. It should be a leak proof while crossing the potable water supply system and should have adequate trap system provided with the necessary water seals to avoid foul gases. It should have a proper slopes. It should require a minimum water for a proper performance and cleaning. See, this is the image of the sanitary drainage system, which has been explained nicely. Stormwater drainage. All building terraces should have proper slopes for carrying rainwater towards a catch point. The total project should be well planned to avoid the accumulation of rainwater in ducts, parking, on roads or in open grounds. Should have well connected stormwater drains with a proper slopes for carrying unused water. These drains should be inspected and maintained properly, especially before rains. See, this is a stormwater drain with a proper coverages. The image has been shown here. Necessity and use of plumbing drawing. Plumbing and sanitation work procedure drawing must include all the minor details. These drawings prove useful as mentioned below. Drawings are useful for calculating the accurate quantity of the material to be used, to coordinate all steps of the plumbing works, to plan and execute the work properly. Proves easy for maintenance of underground and concealed pipes, to provide appropriate accessories for reducing the frictional losses. So this is the image of the residential planning, how it is be the plumbing has to be prepared, has been shown here. Responsibilities of the plumbing contractor. To execute the work, a decent contractor ought to follow the rules given underneath. Ought to get ready in setting up the working drawings and get them endorsed by the neighborhood consultants. Should follow the definite drawings with respect to the pipes work of the task. Ought to envision any useful challenges in completing the work as appeared and roll out the fundamental improvements during the underlying arranging stages. Ought to catch up with the consultant for planning recommendations of water and seepage framework and essential endorsements. It should utilize a group of gifted handymen and talented laborers to guarantee a great workmanship for the venture. He should assist in getting the vital NOC, endorsement and so on after the finish of the work. He should have the option to go any protest about the finished activities and routine support for the equivalent. Expected workmanship. A good plumbing contractor should know all the prevailing rules and complete the works accordingly. Should employ experienced plumbers to execute the job to ensure the good quality work. All practical difficulties should be discussed with the site in charge and the plumbing consultant. This minimizes the repetition of the jobs. Proper tools should be used to execute the required work. The contractor as well as worker should have a sound knowledge of material quality and specification to prevent any mistakes. The plumbing contractor should not spoil other works like plastering, waterproofing, tiling and any other works. He should take the necessary precaution for improving the workmanship of the total project and not of the plumbing work alone. Coordination with other agencies. Plumbing work of the building requires coordination with other agencies to ensure smooth working. Excellent building construction is impossible without a good teamwork, and for the good teamwork, coordination of the all agencies are essential. Advantages of the coordination. Excellent coordination results in quality construction and benefits everyone. The flat fetches a good real estate value for its owners and earns a good reputation for the builders and engineers. Teamwork and coordination result in minimizing defect, less manpower and avoids duplication of the work. Types of agencies involved. Waterproofing agency, masonry and plaster agency, tiling agencies, electrical agencies, painting agencies, departmental agencies. Coordination and role of a waterproofing agency. Waterproofing and plumbing are related activities. They should coordinate to prevent any leakage problems in the future. Pre-work. Sunken floor should be plastered with cementitious mortar 1:4 with waterproofing compound and tested for a water tightness. The first coat of waterproofing should be done before fixing sanitary traps in case of water closets and toilets. The first coat of the waterproofing and brickbed coat should be done before fixing the bends of the rainwater at the terrace level. Finishing the trap joint. How to finish the tranny trap joint has been shown here in the detail. Post work. Sterilized snares and waste lines of wash hand bowls should be very much installed in the bludge gun COBA test. The last completing coat should be done for the latrine and patio after restoring the Blodajan COBA coat. Restoring should be accomplished for 14 days. Insurance should be taken. All the snare joints should be appropriately completed to keep away from any spillages issue later on. On account of patio water pipe, the joint close to curb should be conveniently gotten done with a concrete mortar to forestall spillages. Coordination and role of the machinery plaster agencies. Brickwork and plaster work organization are firmly identified with plumbing as all vertical lines run on surfaces. Covered lines are constantly covered with the brickwork. Henceforth, co-appointment among plumbing and workmanship motor organization is significant. Pre-work. For the most part, all sources are fixed and taken out from the building face or sleeves are given before the outer mortar. Traps should be all around inserted in concreting mortar at the intersection. The dividers of the WAC, furthermore, washroom should be sufficient for pursuing of furrows for disguised lines. Stonework of these dividers must be finished with effectively determined concrete, sand mortar, blend in with RCC grooves per meter tallness. Post work. After concealing the pipes, grooves should be finished with a specified cement sand mortar and the surface should be roughened. After fixing vertical lines, all holes should be plastered with a rich cement sand mortar to prevent any leakages. Necessary precautions. The duct plaster should not be ignored for the quality, plumb, line and level. The plaster over which the vertical pipelines are to be run must be in line and plumb. This point should not be overlooked by the site engineers and the contractors. Improper plastering can cause problems in the plumbing lines later on, like leakages through joints, cracking of the CA fittings, etc. Hence, duct plaster must be done in perfect plumb, line and level. Engineers and contractors to check this. Coordination and role of a tiling agency. Tiling and plumbing works are interlinked. The following are the pre-work and post-work procedures for tiling work with respect to the plumbing work. Pre-work. Generally, tiling is done after laying of plumbing pipe. So, there is hardly any pre-work as per the tiling is concerned. Post-work. All the concealed pipes should be properly placed and tested before fixing the glazed tile dado in the toilet. Wash basin outlets and all the traps should be laid before the bathroom flooring work. Necessary precautions. During polishing, the tile polisher generally sweeps the polished tile powder slurry in the nanny trap and WC, which should be avoided. This causes the pipes to choke up and may be lead to replacing the pipes. To prevent this, the tile powder slurry should be collected and disposed of manually. In addition, the following points should be observed. The opening of IWC should be filled with sand, gunny bags, and the top layer should be covered with a thick layer of POP. Nanny trap hole should be made in the flooring tile after the completion of the polishing work. Coordination and role of electrification agencies. Concealed plumbing and concealed electrification works are interlinked activities as far as bathrooms and toilets are concerned. Since both the activities run simultaneously, pipes should be laid very carefully. Electrical conduits should not cross the plumbing lines so as to prevent short circuits. Coordination and role of a painting agencies. Painting is the final finishing item and starts after 90% of the plumbing is over. Painter should not use the paint in the bathroom wash basin. The sediments of the paints can cause choking of the plumbing line. Care to be taken by the plumber. Choke-up problem of the plumbing lines occurs due to the negligence of other agencies. Plumbers themselves should exercise precaution since handling all agencies at a time is difficult. Plumbers should seal all the traps with the gunny bags and a layer of POP on the top to minimize the choke-up problems. Remove these seals at the time of testing. The site engineer must supervise these activities to avoid any problems. Tools required for plumbing and sanitation work. Following the list of the tools used for plumbing and sanitation works procedure. Plumbing hammers, tape, flat wire, gas piler, plumber's vise, bench vise, chain wrench, pipe wrench, footprint wrench, axle frame with a blade, files, chisels, caulking tools, double-ended spanner set, ring spanner set, extension bar, socket wrench, various handles, various size of the dies, tapi, gamela, etc. List of major materials for plumbing and sanitation works. Materials required for a plumbing and sanitation work procedure can be broadly divided into two categories. That is, material required for internal plumbing and sanitation work and material required for external plumbing and drainage work. All the materials should have adhered to the IS standards. Galvanized materials. GI pipes and fittings are available in various sizes ranging from 15 to 40 mm. GI pipes, elbows, T, union, socket, plugs, etc. etc. Cast iron materials. CI pipes. See the image of the CA pipes, single double sockets, single socket double sock connector, the images will show you, plant plug tees. Plain plug bends, this is the image of the plain plug bends, single double Y in the length of 300 to 450 mm. Nani traps in the diameter 75 to 150 mm. CI chamber covers, CI gully trap covers, CI rainwater shoes, CI offsets, cowls, stoneware RCC items, RCC Hume pipes ranging from NP1 to NP4 grade. Gully traps, 100-150 mm, shiver traps, see this is the image of gully traps, chamber covers, square, round and angular, stoneware pipes, rainwater pipes ranging from 100 to 200 mm, packing rope, that is a rusty molars. Sanitary ware items, wash hand wash basin, Indian water closet, European water closet, Anglo-Indian water closet, bidet, urinals, sinks, soap dish, etc. Urinals, sinks, soap dish. Sanitary fittings. These fittings are utilized to control water stem to washrooms, latrines, water wardrobes, kitchen and so on. These fittings are accessible in metal powder coated chromium plated, that is CP, polyvinyl chloride, iron, and so on. Generally, famous and regular CP fittings are CP fittings, full of strung waste coupling, stop valves of open and covered sort, column tap, sink bowl divider blender, kiddy apron tape, expansion piece with a spine, and so forth. See, these are the images of the various sanitary accessories. Quality checking. CI pipes. Class, color, stripe, diameter, weight, length, visible cracks, etc. Types of classes. Light, medium, and heavy. Nominal diameter available in the market are 15 to 200 mm. The class of pipe indicates the use. Wall thickness of various classes are different. Walls. Types, sizes, cracks, defects, leakages, etc. CP fittings. Type, surface finish, leakages, threading, etc. Trap. Type, material, size, horizontal smoothness, any visible cracks, etc. Sanitary fittings. Type, material, size, any visible cracks, finishing, color, etc. Nahani trap. Material, size, length, water seal, depth, etc. P-trap and S-trap. This is a P-trap and this is an S-trap. Material, sizes, water seal, depth, etc. CI pipes. Should be checked for type, class length, the thickness of the wall, straightness, ISI, non-SI, visible cracks, bends, etc. The type of CI pipes order depend upon its utilization. Soil pipe for WC and toilet lines, while ordinary pipes are used for bath and rainwater downtake. Domestic water supply is provided through LA class CI pipe, which comes in two classes, A and B. CI fittings. The thickness of the wall, internal smoothness, correct indulged angles, visible cracks, brand, etc. Responsibilities of the plumbing consultant. Consultant should be related with the undertaking from the arranging stage and facilitate various phases of the pipe work of a continuous development venture. To give you a drawing, considering neighborhood authority rules and guidelines with respect to gracefully framework, interior channeling, subtleties of all pipes and sterile fittings, general waste removal format, stormwater seepage subtleties, boosting framework subtleties, and so on, to settle levels of the proposed streets and structure to give legitimate slants to the waste, to propose and acquire sanction from the municipal experts for the pipes and disinfection work strategy frameworks, to gather NOC from the concerned experts for the finished work, and to keep up quality control on works during execution, to give testimonials for the nature of workmanship in the wake of testing and checking GI lines at the necessary weight at each stage and CI PVC. Furthermore, different lines for different line, plumbs and slimbages. To set up the last record drawing according to the genuine work execution at the site. Indicate and educate about the quality with respect to materials to be utilized. Customary site visit during the execution of the work until the finish of the task. List of drawing needed. Stormwater drawing, drainage drawing, water supply lines, septic tank, overhead tank, UG tank, terrace level distribution, internal plumbing work details, pump details, pump room arrangement details, any other structure to carry out the plumbing systems, swimming pool if provided, details regarding plumbing requirement, filtration plant, etc. Plumbing detail, sewerage treatment plants if required. Water supply systems. Providing water in residential premises for requirements such as drinking, cooking, washing and cleaning is the main object of water supply system. Water should be free from disease, causing organisms like bacteria, viruses, etc. Free of undesirable taste and odor, clear and colorless. Free of excessive mineral, poisonous material. Underground water in the form of open wells and tube wells. Sources of the water supply. Municipal corporation or a local authority. Borewell and open well at site. Water from these sources should be tested for standard requirements of a potable water. Normally, the municipal water is supposed to be potable and no separate tests required for it. The standard requirement of potable water is attached as a test report. Specimen test report. Sanitation of the water. Wells must be sterilized utilizing weighty portions of chlorines. Bleaching powders can be additionally be utilized for the sanitation of the water. Fading powder contains 25% to 30% chlorine. The last leftover chlorine in water at the shop person should be brought down to 200 mg per liter. The water grab from the municipal corporation is treated at a local plant and sanitized. Periodical looking at can be conveyed to check the level of chloride. Underground water tank. Keep underground water tank 60 cm above the plinth level of the enclosing area. The limit should be 1.5 accretions of the overhead tank. It may be very well both in RCC or in brickwork, etc. Keep the base section of the underground water tank over the groundwater table or more the source level of the septic tank, e.g. water tank, should be away from the septic tank. Subsequent to finishing both top and base section levels, the size can be settled according to the necessary limit, that is 1.5 accretions of the limit of the overhead tank. A freeboard of at least 15 cm should be given. Distribution system from the overhead tank to UG tank. So this is the image of the overhead tank, how it has been connected to the overhead tank and been coming to the various points and go to the building system. Plumbing work. According to the municipality, the quality of the overhead tanks for water stockpiling, the siphon size and the conveyance pipe stabilities will be chosen. The conveyance pipes emerging from the siphon room should be taken subterranean and afterwards to a singular structure. The line utilized should be of C class and precautionary measures should be taken to keep away from spillages because of flawed association, and so forth. All curves utilized for the association ought to have placed twist in order to limit the frictional misfortunes. GATs are given to take out the branches from the main line close to each building. Ball rooster plants should be given at gulf to stop the progression of approaching water when it comes to the freeboard level. A different door wall should be given at about 9 meter, which can be utilized to keep the water from adding to the specific overhead tank on the equivalent main time. A reasonable siphon controlling framework should be utilized according to the necessity of the venture. Pump details. Usually the pressure from service mains is not sufficient to take the water up to the overhead tank. So the service main connection is provided into UG water tank. The water is then pumped to the overhead water tank, from where it is supplied to the individual unit by gravity through a network of pipes and valves. Refer figure of the water supply network. Terms of pumps. Single phase and three phase. Positive suction pumps. Negative suction pumps. Self-priming pumps. Pumps where priming is required. Submersible pumps. Jet pumps. Turbine pumps. Reciprocating pumps, etc. See, these are the images of the various type of the pumps has been provided. Procedure for laying vertical GA lines. Determine the location from where the lines are to be taken. Make the plumb line for vertical stakes to be fixed on the wall. Erect the scaffolding without making any holes in the walls. Take a vertical support from the windows inside and tie it properly. Fix the pipes on the wall with clips and GI nails of 40 mm length. Clipping should be done at a spacing of 1.5 to 2 meter. All the holes should be filled with brick block pieces and should be finished with rich cement mortar. Do not remove the scaffolding unless all the holes are properly finished. Internal plumbing system, conceal type. Generally, concealed plumbing is required in bathroom and toilets. Different steps involved in this are as follows. Plaster an internal of the both toilets. Make the line on walls with a chalk in proper alignment and plumb as per the recommended heights and internal plumbing drawings. Start chasing the wall using a chisel and hammer. The chasing should be done keeping the following points in mind. These are the images of to check the pressure test. Depth should not record the pipe size, which should be sufficient to accommodate the pipeline. Alignment should be done considering the straightness. Height should be as per the specifications. For columns and other RCC work, chasing should be strictly avoided. Check the class of the specification of material. Preferably C-class GA pipes should be used. Fitting should be checked for their correctness, cracks, etc. Prepare the pipe skeleton and check all the joints for tightness. The water tightness on the line can be checked using pressure testing equipment. The image was shown in the previous slide. The pressure reading should be between 5 to 10 kgs per centimeter square, and even a single drop of water should not escape the joints during testing. Apply cold tar over skeleton with a brush. Cover the skeleton, including fittings, with a hazine cloth and tie it properly. Fix the skeleton on wall using 40mm plumbing nails at a distance of 9 inches on alternative sides. Plaster the line with a cement and sand mortar. For the portion where glass tile is dado is prepared, the plaster surface to be roughened. Curing should be done for the gaps for at least 7 days. Typical plumbing layout for a bath and WHP kitchen lines. Generally, bath WC in residential building construction are located near each other for a better planning and economical plumbing system. Shows a layout of the plumbing work as a guidelines for economical and easy construction. GA fittings and their uses. Union. It is a fitting used to connect two pipes. It is used at the beginning of a pipe system inside the room. Standard size of plumb fitting. The various fittings plumbing work should be provided at height as per the specification of the drawing. For all appliances, midway between two long pipelines. Union enables repair and replacement of the pipeline system without disturbing the other parts of the system. Some of the parts used in the construction. Bend, it connects two pipes at a required angle. T, it is a fitting with a side outlet of 90 degree. Cross T, it is a fitting with four branches arranged in pairs, each at right angles. Reducer, this fitting is larger at one end and smaller at the other end. It is used to connect pipes of two different sizes. Reducer T, reducer elbow, reducer bend, reducer socket. Barrel nipple. It is a piece of a pipe threaded at both ends and can be used for a short extension of the plumbing area. Double nipple. It is used to connect two fittings within the short distance. It has thread on both sides at the central piece. Plug. It has an exterior pipe thread end and projecting head for fittings at the socket. Clamps. They are used for tightening the pipes to the walls of the vertical and horizontal lines. They are available in various sizes of the pipes. Plumbing nails. Usually plumbing nails sizes 50 to 75 mm are used, can be hammered for a clamps over RCC. Air valve. When water mains are in undulating position, they should be provided with an air outlet valves at the highest point. These valves release the air trapped in the mains when the intensity of water flow being is changed. These valves consist of a floating ball which allow the air to escape but is set back by pressure when comes into contact with the water. Socket. These fittings are used to connect one link to another for the continuation of the pipe. Elbow. It connects two pipes at 90 degree and has a short elevation. Push tap. In order to prevent undue wastage of water in factories, schools and similar buildings, self-closing taps are often used. They are particularly used for wash basin and equipment used for drinking water purpose. Generally, it's a bib tap with a horizontal inlet. Sluice valve. It controls the flow of water from the source to the town or area when water distribution is to be done. These are fixed at intervals of 3 to 5 km. So divide the pipeline in different sections. These valves are also fixed on distribution pipes. They are normally controlled by a wheel. Pillar tap. It has a vertical inlet and is provided on wash basin. It is either bent down at a 90 degrees or at an angle called as an angular pillar tap. Water meters. Water meter measures the flow of water from a main line to the house service connection. The water meter should conform IS 779. Domestic water meters are usually the horizontal type. Normal sizes are ranging from 50 to 50 mm. Selection, installation and maintenance should conform IS 2401. A filter is fitted on the upstream, that is the inlet side of the water meter. Any air passing through the water meter will give inaccurate readings. Non-return valve should be provided on its downstream, that is the outlet side. Water meters are placed in a meter box at a higher level to avoid flood during the rains. Domestic water meter testing should be as per IS 6784. The domestic water meter box should be as per 2104. Distribution from overhead water tank to individual unit. Overhead water tank, it is usually rectangular in shape and mostly covers the staircase opening. The capacity of the tank is adjusted by varying the depth of the tank. Overhead water tank usually rectangular in shape because of design constraint. The capacity can be worked out by assuming the water requirement as 135 liter persons per day. To place the inlet and outlet and washout pipes in position, the provision should be made while concreting. An opening size of 60 by 90 cm is provided in overhead tank top slab as a manhole cover. Gate walls for each outlet, that is bath, WC, line and kitchen line, should be provided on the terrace parapet for easy maintenance and replacement. The overflow should be provided 25 mm to 50 mm below the inlet. Washout should be flush with the finished floor and plugged properly when not in operation. The pipeline from overhead water tank to the individual unit should have a minimum length of run and bends. Gate wall for each outlet should be provided. Firefighting system requirement as per the municipal norms. If the height of the building exceeds 15 meter or 25 meter according to the city, the firefighting system must be installed as per the municipal corporation rules. Checklist for plumbing work. All fixtures are bib tacked, fixed properly. Is there any leakage from taps and other fixtures? Is there proper pressure on the taps and cocks? Is the off-turn flush cock operation is proper? Is there any choke up in WC after continuous flow of water ஃப்ரம் ஆஃப்டர்ன் ஃப்ளஷ் காக் ஃபார் அட்லீஸ்ட் 5 மினிட்ஸ். இது எனி சிமண்டலம் அப்சர்வ்ட் இன் த பி ட்ராப் ஆஃப் த டபிள்யூசி. இது எனி சோக்கப் இன் த நானி ட்ராப் அட் த பாத்ரூம். இஸ் த ஹாட் அண்ட் கோல்ட் வாட்டர் மிக்சர் ஆப்ரேஷன் இஸ் ப்ராப்பர். ஆர் த பாய்லர் கனெக்ஷன் ஆஸ் லெஃப்ட் பிளக்ட். இஸ் த லோவர் லெவல் வாட்டர் டேங்க் ஆப்ரேஷன் ஆஃப் இடபிள்யூசி இஸ் ப்ராப்பர். இஸ் த சீட் கவர் ஆஃப் த இடபிள்யூசி இஸ் ஃபிக்ஸ் ப்ராப்பர்லி. ஆர் ஆல் சானிட்டரி ஃபிக்சர்ஸ் ப்ராப்பர்லி க்ளீன். ஆல் த பிராக்கெட்ஸ் ஆஃப் டபிள்யூஹெச்பி பெயிண்டட் வித் ஆயில் பெயிண்ட்ஸ். ஆர் த ஓப்பன்ஸ் GI fittings are connected with the EC, EWC is painted. Is the wash basin fitted properly? Or there is any crackage in the sanitary fittings? Any leakage from CI lines to the duct? Is the fixing of CI, GI, AC lines in plumb and clamped properly? Is there any leakage in the drainage chamber? Is there any leakage in the main inlet and outlet GI lines of the water tanks? Are there any cracks on white cement filled between wash basin and wall? Are PVC outlet pipes for wash hand basin and kitchen are fixed properly? Is there any separate mark for municipal water tap and tap water from the overhead water tank? Are escape valves from the WC or bath are provided? Points ignored by the engineer. Since plumbing is a significant help in development work, the site engineer must have sound information on pipe procedure. Most pipe issues happens because of the handyman and in the absence of the plumbing skill. Working with a thumb rule should be dodged. The site designer ought to notice to the accompanying principles. Continuously demand handyman with a permit and gifted laborers at the site. Check all pipes material for quality. The class of GI lines should be checked by shading, coding and furthermore by test gauging. Demand that legitimate instrument be utilized by the handyman at the site. Plan all perquisites appropriately to try not to utilize the accessible fittings and lines rather than the correct materials. Never depend upon the perquisites sizes determined by the handyman. Demand point by plumbing drawings alongside amount assessment by the advisor before the beginning of any work. Guarantee least wastages while cutting off full length pipes. The engineer shall have sufficient knowledge of the staking and handling of the plumbing material. Any mishandlings should be checked immediately and such personnel should be removed from the work. Even if the plumbing system is concealed, always insist on the proper alignment and verticality of the pipelines. Pressure checking for leakage plumbing and lines is a must. It should be supervised personally and use of the pressure gauge equipment should be ensured. Ensure sufficient knowledge of municipal standard and regulations. Arrange plumbing work in coordination with other contractor. This prevents mistakes, delays, repetition of the works, etc. Insist on the employment of skilled mason by the plumbing contractor. Never allow plumbing helpers to finish the gaps. Insist on a proper curing for the plumbing gabbras. Do not succumb to the pressure tactics of the plumbing contractor. Dues for plumbing work. Check the top level of the nanny trap before waterproofing work. Apply Kaitan over coal tar on all concealed GI lines. Fix all concealed GI lines in position firmly with a 40 mm plumbing nails. Ensure proper curing for all gaps works and finishing at the concealed lines. Issue material required for a specific day. Consider the floor thickness, that is FFL, before finalizing the heights of the fittings. Ensure that all GI lines are in plumb. Ensure proper clippings to the pipelines of the external side. Make proper ball valve arrangement for inlets of overhead and UG water tank. Don't in plumbing works. Don't start the plastering work for concealed GI lines before checking the leakages using the pressure gauge. Don't leave GI portion outside the plaster finish or glaze tile box. Don't keep the open GI pipeline unpainted. Don't damage any waterproofing work during plumbing. Don't keep the nanny trap, P-trap, etc. unplugged. Don't keep the opening of the GI pipelines unplugged before starting the internal plaster. Don't start the pumping operation before checking for priming. Don't allow tools fixing of WHB. Thank you for watching this presentation. In the next presentation, we will talk about external drainages. Kindly subscribe, like and share, which will motivate me for a further good presentation. In case of any queries, do not hesitate to write to me. The response shall be at the earliest. Image courtesy Google. Courtesy of various articles from plumbing handbooks and various websites. Contact me, civilconclave@gmail.com or at my Telegram group, Ask Srini Telegram group. The link has been as follows. Kindly subscribe, like and share, which will motivate me for a further good presentation. Thank you for watching once again. Kindly subscribe.